All right, today we're going to be going over the one and only Overkill bench shirt. Ta-da! I've been lucky enough to use it a few times. Still relatively fresh. I think I've used it, honestly, 3 times. And yeah. it's still holding up like I just opened up the package. So the great thing about Overkill is it's a custom-made shirt, so you're not going to be ordering from some website or from some customer service rep and just giving them a general size. You literally have to fill out a form and do exact measurements for these whenever you order them. And it takes a little bit longer, but that's really what you're wanting when you're wanting to get into multiply gear. You're wanting something that's going to be custom form-fitting to you.
Oh, for sure. That was the biggest problem I had with all of my bench shirts previous to getting this one. Yeah. I was actually single ply before I went to multi ply. And the issue with the Titan shirts, which are great, the issue for me is they wouldn't go all the way up my arms.
Right.
And I tried 3 different shirts from them, I think, and just couldn't find one that worked.
But it's always going to be something. Mm-hmm. It's something's going to fit okay, and then the rest of it's just kind of just be floating around on you.
Then I got into the Inzer shirts. They were easier to work in than the Titan shirts. You could wear them looser because it's multiply. So you don't have to get super, super tight to be able to make it work. But the issues with those, I was having the collar stretch on them and everything. So
That's going to be another topic we'll talk about later is the Inzer, because I've actually had one of mine blow out on me in the middle of a meet on my first attempt, and that sucked.
Yeah.
That sucked, and it was the collar. It was the chest. But these, I've honestly, I mean, I haven't gone, for me, it's heavy, but I haven't gone too heavy in regards to what I know this is capable of. I've hit about 435 to a 2-board, or close to a 2-board.
Sounds about right.
Yeah, somewhere around there. This man, on the other hand, has actually taken it for a ride a couple of times, and we actually have video footage that I'll loop into here so you guys can see it. As far as your use with this, what is your favorite, what is your favorite aspect of this shirt when it comes to using it?
The fit for me is the biggest thing because it's, of course, custom.
Right.
It works for me better so far than any other shirt I've used. It now has a bigger learning curve than any other shirt. I had a few sessions where I started going, oh boy, I might need to get this Inzer shirt fixed as a backup for my meet because I didn't know how well this was going to go breaking this one in. But turned out I just wasn't using enough weight for it.
Now let me ask you this, to kind of, for anybody who hasn't actually used multiply, maybe you've dabbled like myself. It's funny you said it because I dabbled in single ply first. And I think that's pretty much the progression for most lifters. Raw, single ply, and you go, what the hell am I doing? Let's just go all the way. But that was kind of one of the things that I thought was interesting when I used the third brand. And you really don't get that opinion until you use multiple brands, at least 3 of them. They all have a groove. Most of them have a groove. They'll have a way to actually set it into the shirt. Like we were talking about earlier, this is a custom fit, so it's going to feel a lot more different than one of those off the rack pulls that you get from Inzer or metal or whatnot. But going back to what you were talking about, figuring out actually where it sits on your chest and whatnot, did you like it better as far as filling it into the groove?
So the thing with this one is it's going to have a smaller margin for error.
Right.
So it's going to make you bench the way it's going to make you bench. So you're going to have your groove you have to hit with that shirt, and you can't really play around with it all that much. I actually found with this shirt, I didn't have to bring the collar down as much as, say, an SDP to make it work good for me. The SDPs, you could bring the collar up and have a higher
groove. Think it's because they're not custom. So, yeah. I mean, you pull it all the way down, you can bring it up, you can fold the sleeves a little bit, you can manipulate the shirt, and you have to actually manipulate the shirt because it's not a custom shirt. You know, I'm not knocking it. I will say right now, I've hit some pretty good numbers in SDP before, but there's a lot of manipulating and adjusting while you're in the shirt. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually show you guys a couple of videos right now.
Out under the bar. Hold it.
Good.
But we're going to go over the options of what they do have. Right now, we'll just go over the red line shirt. The red line shirt, it comes in single ply. You can order this in single ply. It's just $200. That's a really good freaking deal. They also offer a one ply with two ply sleeves. So it'll be a one ply chest with two ply sleeves for $225. Again, that's like insanely good. That's a really good freaking deal. All of this, I'll just say this right now, all of it's a really good damn deal if you're looking for quality and you want to pay for something quality. Mm-hmm. It's a good price.
Because the thing you got to think about is if you want a shirt that's going to perform like this will, say in an Enzer, you've got to get yourself your stock one, try it on, because that stock size is going to be different. It's not going to always be the same. Well,
to be honest with you, the same size might always be different. Like, it's not bad that happened.
Material they're using, who's making it. The seamstress, Rudy makes that himself.
Yeah.
No one else is going to make that, just him. So it's going to be the same.
Yep.
That's the one thing you could say about Overkill. The quality control is just...
When you have one person doing it, that's damn good quality control. You don't have to control anybody else. You're the factor. So it's going to be consistent.
But I think where I was getting at with that is, like, you buy a brand new shirt from another company, that's not the only money you're spending on. You got to spend the money to go send that off and get it tailored and make it fit to you perfectly.
That's right. That is right. Going on to keep building on that.
Yeah.
So again, we were at a one ply chest with two ply sleeves. That's $225. Now you get into a two ply shirt. This is a two ply shirt. That's $265. Then you can have a two ply chest, three ply sleeves for $290, and then the ultimate three ply for $340. Does he really? Wouldn't surprise me. I felt really bad about myself if it was a two ply. Like when I was watching him, Zach can lift some weight. So can this gentleman. But when he was there, I was like, damn, has he got a two ply? I feel really shitty about myself right now.
I think it, don't quote me on that, but it's either a three ply or a two chest, three sleeves. I'm not sure.
Now, so we should actually build on that as well. So when we're talking about one ply chest, two ply sleeves, when you're benching, you should actually know, any raw bencher should actually know this too. There are certain muscle groups that come into play in the bench press movement. Yes, of course, it's a chest movement. But when you're benching with gear, it's a whole different game. So you will be utilizing a lot of your triceps. Mostly triceps in your bench. You'll be also putting a lot in your back, of course, and so on and so forth. But there's a lot of emphasis in your triceps. So that's why there would be that option to have a higher ply sleeve on your shirt. So going into, and we'll do this real quick. I haven't had this. I know you said you haven't had the black line. I definitely, now that we're talking about it, it'd be like one of the things. You know what?
It looks like
we're going to order one. We're going to order one for Nick, and we're going to order one for myself, and we're going to see how horrible it fucking is. Yeah.
It looks like it's the same options, just with his black material.
Oh, yeah, it is. It is. So it's the same exact. You can get the one ply for the same exact price, one ply chest, two ply sleeves, $225, same exact price, and so on and so forth, all the way up to the three ply.
Difference, it does have a disclaimer that it is an extreme shirt that should be worn by experts.
Yeah.
So take that however you will.
Seriously.
I will say you see a lot more of the red ones nowadays.
Yeah.
I have seen people in the black ones, but I think the red ones are really picking up popularity. It's a nice shirt.
We'll post pictures of each one of the shirts. Speaking of, another little thing that is, and it's kind of just one of those, if you like it, you can get it added on. If you don't like it, don't worry about it. But a lot of these custom shirts that he provides, I think all of them actually, come with, let me stand up so you can see it, come with the Velcro option in the back.
I believe all of them do.
Yeah. You can, but going to what I want to get into, though, you can actually get a double Velcro. You can actually get triple Velcro up there. I just have the single. Does yours have
mine's
two?
Double.
Yours, yeah.
So all sometimes it is really, it's just a strip that comes off and you can move it anywhere in the back you want it. So if you want your Velcro to hook up at the shoulders right here. You can move it up there. You can put it down at the bottom. I mean, it's as adjustable as you need it to be. Yeah.
And if you ever lose one, the great thing about it is if you ever lose one, most of these are stitched onto it. So once this material is done, you actually have to go to a seamstress or a tailor and actually have them manipulate it for you. The great idea behind that, and it's so simple, is it's just a piece of Velcro. Literally, you can buy this stuff anywhere. If it goes wonky on you, you can just replace it. If you don't like the big strip, you can replace it with a small one. You can cut it, whatever you want to do. It's a great idea, though. I know my SDP, that's stitched on there. So yeah. it's actually where it's at.
It's going to hook up where it's going to hook up, yep. And you're going to like it.
Yep. And I'll be honest with you, I really don't like where it actually ends up on my back. So everything else is already uncomfortable. The last thing I want to worry about is how uncomfortable I feel on my back as well. And you'd be surprised. That's the one thing that you can feel. Can't feel anything else when you're in a fitted suit. But for some reason, you can feel your back. It's really weird. But yeah, so that is actually a brief recap of the Overkill shirt.